Paid for it. Yeah, you know, that's a kind of cool thing. Oh, by the way, this is the number 12 of the Rose 32 Etudes. And yeah, I was just saying, you know, if you're going to play these on bass clarinet and you have the opportunity to use some of those extended notes, especially that low D, especially when we're in the key of D minor, heck, why not? So, you know, Rose isn't going to come after you and shoot you. This is the sort of kind of trumped up melodrama of this part of the book. It's very furioso, and it's, you know, it's kind of, well, whatever. It is what it is. How do we approach it? What is this etude about? So, in my opinion, it's very similar to number 10, which I've also done. And it's, and the point being that there, it's about nibbleness of your tongue. But in this case, there's not as much tonguing in it as there was in number 10. Here you're sort of, in the beginning, you're slurring two. So the whole point of this part is you never want to go. We've talked about this a lot in this series. You want to have one stream of air that you punctuate with your tongue, but you don't close the air off. So closing the air off would sound like this. Because when you do that, and you notice I exaggerated, it's not even anymore. It doesn't sound even. Even if it was even, it wouldn't sound even. So what you want to do, one big stream of air that goes through the whole thing. Okay, now right after this particular part, what you might want to check out is how you can actually lead to each beat. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. A lot of music that you play, you know, there are notes that lead to a downbeat or lead to a main beat in the measure. This is a great time to start practicing doing that. So what you definitely don't want to do is, because then you lose where the beat is. So really go for each of those beats. Cool. Let's see, what else about this? You'll notice that when I'm playing it, I actually hold certain notes for a little while longer. Now, we've talked about this in another one of these videos, but the point is, I need to collect, this is constant, this is straight 16th notes on the page. Oh well. The point being is that you need to give your brain and your fingers a place to collect themselves. Otherwise, you'll start tripping over yourself. Now, I mean, this is an especially difficult one to be able to kind of play all the way through without stopping, because there's very little place for you to breathe. There's very little place for you to collect yourself. So you just got to plant those in there. Write them in with your pencil where you are planning to collect. This, we were talking about Tarzan notes. Go back and look at that. I'll put the link up to the video where we talk about Tarzan notes. That was etude number 6. You want to be able to write in and then remember where it is that you're going to spend just a fraction of a second longer on that note, and then move to the next passage. It breaks these long passages of 16th notes up into smaller, more easily managed bite-sized pieces. Okay? And enjoy those low Ds if you got them on your bass clarinet. See you next time.